What is up, everybody? This is Moose, and this is CTF Vitalism B2, this week's UGC Highlander map. Now, CTF Vitalism is a little bit different than what you're used to with CTF maps. Usually you take the intel from their base back to your base, but this one's a little different. We'll be getting into that in just a little bit. Before I start, I have chosen instrumental hip-hop as my music genre this week. Hopefully it does stay instrumental and doesn't get too many lyrics in the background that could get distracting. But otherwise, I figured it would keep things alive. I tried piano, and piano almost put me to sleep. So we're going to try this out today. But let's go ahead and get started. Two spawn areas, very offset from one another, 1-2 on both sides. And the difference between these is actually huge. This is the red base, and the intel is kind of in the middle of this red base. The whole thing is symmetrical, but so you've got two ways out, left or right. Usually, well, from what I've seen, teams will mostly spawn together over on the right, or mostly all together over on the left. Now, if your medic ends up getting separated, that could be a problem. So your medic might want to have an explode bind just in case he has no one to heal right out the gate. Anyways, so you can come out one of three ways, actually. One is out the right side exit, either lower or upper, and we'll talk about the benefits of these in just a second. You can go kind of a long way out, come out through a door, go to this middle area by your intel, up the stairs, and push out over the pipes right up to the upper shed area, or the upper middle area, or you can come out to the left, and that's very similar to what's over on the right. It's basically the same idea, left or upper or lower, and that gets you out to the yard on either left or right rollouts. Let's talk about positioning a little bit here. If you guys watch Hindsight, which I just posted this morning, you'll know I talked about this a little bit. We're just going to go through each class and kind of talk about what each class should be doing as a map, and then I can talk about what the team should be doing as a whole. Now, scouts, this map is very prone to being very flanky because it's very short and very wide. Now, scouts can get around dozens of different ways and get around the enemy team and get a flank and get a good strong pick or two before he's recognized and has to retreat. That can be really powerful. So if a scout comes out the left side here, he's got a dozen options. He can come through the shed, he can jump over the wall and push into the lower shed area, or the lower middle area. He can go to the right through the middle, or across. He can go right across underneath the pipes over to the right side. He can come from under here. You can actually jump back up top here, and I'm lagging out. I'm sorry, guys, that was horrible. My laptop's been really crappy recently. He can come up top here. He can then fall through if he needs to. He can jump out the windows. He can jump out through here and get across the other enemy pipes. He can jump out this window and get across to his team. A thousand different directions the scout can go, you know, and he'll be using every single one of them. If your scout's really good at DM, I would almost recommend that you just have him DM the entire time and not worry about capping. There's eight other classes that can cap the intel, so I'll talk about that a little bit more later. Soldiers, you're gonna love this map because it's got a huge skybox. You don't hit your head trying to jump over anything, which means you can go for some huge picks. Maybe roll out to the left here, use this wall, and jump around and curve around and land right here. It can be done. And try to get a force out of that. You can jump up from here. If you go take the top, you can jump from here and curve around. That's slightly easier. You can pogo pretty much all the way across the top. If you pogo off this right wall, you can pogo off these rocks and land, you know, in this area. 100 things you can do. Just try it out, jump around, see what you can find. Make sure you use it. You can stand on top of this shed, so be sure to do that if necessary. Pyros, you have the ability to kind of float around your medic, but because this map is so spy favorable, I would just kind of recommend you stick around your medic and check the flanks for him and make sure he's not going to get caught out. Demo men are actually going to be one of the primary cappers on this map because they're so quick about it. They can come up here through the top, over the pipes, drop down on the intel, place a sticky as they're falling, grab it, and then sticky right back up. In addition, there are a lot of places for sticky traps over any of these doors, maybe over this door, in the hay bales here, the stickies will clip through, right outside their cap area, and I'll go over that in a second. Outside, obviously, their doors on the left or right, there's just plenty of places for your Domian to sticky trap. If that's what suits him, obviously, you can just M1, M2 your way to victory as well. Heavy should be obviously with the medic, kind of protecting this central area, and I'll talk about the importance of that when we talk about teams. What else am I missing? Engineer. Mini sentries with Wranglers are massive on this map. You can come over here, mini sentry Wrangler, all the way across the map. You can get up top, maybe. Up here, put a Wrangler down and just kind of deny a whole half of the map. You can put a level 3 down here and protect this lower area. You can put a level 3 or a mini sentry down here and kind of protect the cap area. Obviously, you've got a lot of corners you can work with and hide your sentry in. This being one of them, over here being one of them, maybe in the middle here to protect two sides of this shed, one over on the right and the actual intel itself. Plenty of places for you to put your sentries. It really depends on your playstyle. If you're more of a level 3 engineer, just play it safe and protect your intel. It can get boring because you could be playing for up to 40 minutes just sitting around smacking your mini or your full sentry. But if you're a mini sentry engineer, you're going to love it because you've got huge sight lines and you're going to know what to do, where to put your Wrangler, and you're going to have a good time with this map. Medics, obviously, spread the heals, stick with your heavy, stick with your combo. Make sure your pyro is checking your six at all times. If he's not, yell at him a little bit. You medics are good at that. Sniper. What I found is that this is a powerful spot. Not only can you snipe across or down in there, but if a team decides to push out here, and I talk about this again in hindsight, you can snipe someone all the way across here. And obviously you can do that from the middle as well. You can snipe anyone trying to come over from the left area there. Depends on what you're more comfortable with, but that doesn't mean you're limited. You can snipe from I think it's the right side of both maps. You have a really good view of the middle upper door there, but on the left side of each map you've also got decent sight lines. You can't see that upper middle door, which makes it not as viable, but teams that know this are less likely to really be careful about the left side, so it's all up to you and how tricky you want to be. And that leaves with Spy, and again, just like Scout, Spies have all the flank routes in the world. Not too much metal for them to get away doing a lot of cloak and dagger work. You got to be really careful about that, or rather dead ringer work. There's some right here, and the engineer should know this as well, and across the map over in this shed. I think there's a small pack or medium pack on either side of these pipes across from the steps. I'm not sure if there's any upstairs. I don't believe there are, and I don't believe there are down here. And then there's spawn, which actually isn't that far away from anything. So whatever you're most comfortable with, as far as that goes, remember where those ammo packs are just in case you need to use them. But once again, Spy, just go for the medic picks, whatever you can. Remember, their big classes on this map are going to be their sniper, their spy, their scout, and their pyro to keep their medic alive from you. So make those some of your priorities. Heavy is really limited, but I'll talk about that more in a second. Now, when it comes to capping, you're used to grabbing their intel and then going back all the way to your base and capping it here, right? That's not going to be the case. It's more like a Quake-style CTF, where if they're holding your intel, you cannot cap, and vice versa. If you're holding their intel, they cannot cap. The capture points are also in the middle here, so if you grab, say, the blue intel, you would take it into here, and that's how you cap. Blue would have to take the red intel into this room. But again, I wouldn't spend too much time in here. Definitely do not set up an engineer in this point, because if the other enemy grabs your intel, this door shuts. There's a metal door here that shuts that cannot be opened until they drop your intel or your intel resets. Now, there is a good side to this. If you drop the intel, it resets in about 5 seconds. So be sure, you don't have to really worry about camping an intel drop or whatever if they drop it out at mid. As long as you can keep the other team off it for 5 seconds, your intel is going to reset. Now, team play, there are a couple things you can do. One is to obviously just sit around the middle point, or the intel flag, and just sit here and turtle, and do not let them touch your intelligence whatsoever. There are only a couple doors you have to shut off, which would be this door, and up top. And that's how you shut off this entire room. They would have to Uber in, take out your sentry, take out your heavy, in order to do that. Now, if you're going to sit up here, remember to stay safe from the sniper. He's got a crazy sight line. Like, I can see the deck from over here right on top of this pipe. So you put medic up here or down here somewhere, maybe in the back here. Somewhere, obviously, that your team can get to you for heals. But in addition, you're going to be sacrificing offensive power. If you leave most of your classes defending this, you're only going to have 3 or 4 up that are going to be able to push out and grab their intel. Now, if they're doing the same thing, you guys are never going to go anywhere. You'd have to wait for them to get really aggressive and push a bunch of numbers and then go cap their intel, which could get really slow. It will end up taking the whole 40 minutes to play, and that can be really boring. Not the kind of play style I advocate. I'm more of an aggressive player. The second option, or the more preferable option, is to defend the middle point. Upper and lower, obviously. If you can protect your capture point and they can't stop you from ever making it to this point, you're just going to be able to chain cap. Now, what you do here is you would probably split two of your heavy, one or two, like a heavy and a middle class, like your soldier and your pyro up here. Just protecting the door. Heavy, medic, engineer, any other flanking classes that are not in pursuit of lone picks in here. They'll cycle through here, get their heals. Demo Man, if you do this, is going to be actually one of your fastest cappers. What he can do is he can jump up from the bottom up to here, run across, like I said earlier, go and cap, jump back, and I'm going to lag here again real quick, as I'm sorry. He can go back and capture the point and get his buffs, jump up again. If he dies, obviously, the soldier can sit here, take the heals, and if your demo man dies, he can take that roll. He can jump down here, rocket jump back up onto the platform, and cap the point. That is preferable. Make sure that you are also protecting your sides. You definitely don't want the enemy team flanking from both sides and kind of capturing your medic in here. A lot of teams will try to take their enemy's stairs and hold it, or hold up front in the shed as aggressively as they can while not getting picked. But do not abandon your sides. That can be a huge flank route and completely change the game if your medic goes down. Momentum is huge. If you've wiped them, set up your defense as quickly as you can, as far forward as you can, and just use that momentum, capture it once or twice at least to get ahead. If you get wiped, get around your intel as quickly as you can. Make sure that any single players that are trying to cap it die before they can get away with it. That way, you give up as few points as possible. That's really about it for Vitalism. Again, don't forget your sides. Be sure to exploit your flanking classes. Do what works best for your team. If your team's more passive, obviously sit around your intel. Cut people off as they try to get to you and take them out. If you're aggressive, be sure to use that to your advantage. Take the barn and be ruthless. So this map works for both playstyles. Otherwise, it's not difficult. Don't forget to cap the point once you actually have it. I've seen teams running around with the enemy's intel for a good minute or two before they remember to cap, which is kind of embarrassing, but don't forget to do that, guys. Otherwise, that is Vitalism, and this is Moose signing out.